Virgo. All persons born from August 21st to September 22nd, inclusive, were born under the sign of Virgo. Virgo is the sign of the Virgin, and is the middle sign of the Earth's triplicity, and the people of this sign are usually cool, calm and confident, great and grand qualities, which can bring one to the highest success and happiness. In India, the yogic astrologers tell the Virgo people their faults and bad tendencies so that they may correct them and thus reach the high position in life which is theirs by birth under this excellent sign. You can and must excel in everything you undertake. To think of failure is very, very foolish and weakening. Always have hope and courage, and you will draw and attract to yourself wonderful power and force. Fight with strong will and grim determination every obstacle that crosses your path, whether it be sickness, adversity or poverty. You can win every time. You are fully adapted to a business or a professional career, and will be a marked success in whatever calling you select, provided you will kill entirely all low, vulgar and selfish tendencies. Your sign represents the hidden fire of the earth, which means you are an all-powerful, forceful being. Learn at once that order and method in your habits are absolutely essential to your happiness, success and well-being. Order is heaven's first law. Think and observe much, and order your life so that you will do everything in an orderly, methodical and systematic way. Strive strenuously to fully develop all the good that is in you. Give much attention to your higher nature. Improve yourself morally, spiritually and intellectually. The only force in this universe is the force of good, the force of God. A beautiful and happy life can only be attained by aspiring for good the highest. The study of philosophy, occult science and metaphysics will open your mind to a wealth of happiness you little dream of. Always be generous, kind and loyal. Many excellent scholars and musicians are found in this sign, and we always urge Virgo persons of either sex to study much, read much and give a great deal of time to hearing music. Music is very inspiring and helpful to you, and if you have any inclination to play or sing, don't hesitate in cultivating your taste in this direction. The pronounced faults of the Virgo people are a too strong desire to rule and dominate over people, seeing the faults of others and not seeing their own weak points. False pride and false ambition. Meddling with other people's business and affairs and not attending strictly to their own business. Taking drugs and medicines for imaginary diseases and ailments. Conceit, vanity and egotism. Falsehood, misrepresentation, exaggeration and making extravagant statements about matters and things, especially with regard to their achievements. Running in debt for the sake of keeping up appearances. All of these bad qualities are likely to appear in the lower, uneducated and uncultivated persons of this sign, and if you have any or all of these tendencies, I advise you to root them out of your being once and for all time, as they will be the millstones around your neck, which will keep you from rising to a superior position. I do not know of a higher or grander character than the highly developed Virgo person, or of a meaner and lower being when the sign lives on the low plane in ignorance and darkness. So you see, it is of the utmost importance for you to cultivate your higher nature, which is always true and grand. With respect to health, the Virgo people are naturally healthy persons, and do not need drugs or medicines. Outdoor exercise, lots of air and sunshine will keep you well, strong and vigorous. In love you will be successful when you learn to not be too critical or exacting. If not married, you will do well to select a life partner who is cheerful and does not look on the dark side of life. If you are married, you can make your home a very happy one by not expecting too much from your wife or husband. Your weak point is seeing faults in others and often a married. Virgo person carries his criticism into his or her married life and sees too many faults in the chosen wife or husband. Spend much time with nature in the green fields and woods. Love animals and surround yourself with flowers and domestic pets. If you will be temperate in your eating and don't drug and dose yourself with medicines, you can live many years and retain youthful spirits and vigor up to the time you pass on to the other world. The elixir of life is yours if you will only realize that everything in this world is all right and running in perfect order, directed and guided by the wise one who rules all. You may think you could run this universe better than it is run, but don't attempt it unless you wish to make yourself miserable and destroy your great natural powers and forces. Give yourself a frequent careful examination, looking out for your own bad faults or tendencies, and don't waste any of your time and energy in picking out the flaws in others. In this world, the law is that we find exactly what we look for. If we look for bad, bad will come to us. If we think weakness, failure, poverty and that sort of thing, we will certainly get our full share of weakness, failure, poverty, etc. As a man thinks, so will he be. Poverty is very galling to Virgo people, and they can never amass money until they live on a high plane. That is to say, as long as they brood, whine, grumble, complain and murmur over their lot, just so long they will remain poor and miserable. But, on the other hand, let the Virgo person wake up and cast out all fear and doubt, be up and doing with a cheerful spirit and a high motive, then will he or she have success beyond their fondest hopes. You have everything to live for and can have prosperity and happiness by doing as I suggest. This sign is governed by Mercury, and the gems are pink jasper and hyacinth. The astral colors are gold and black, speckled with blue dots. The diseases which you are most likely to suffer from are stomach troubles and nervousness. Your best companions are those born in Libra, Sagittarius and in your own sign Virgo. People born in this sign are usually of middle stature and well-formed, with noble faces. May the peace and blessing of the Blessed One, and all the Devas, angels and all the yogis of the universe be ever with you, dear sister or brother of Virgo. Bhakti Seva. Cusps. If your first breath was drawn when one sign was taking the place of another, you will partake of the characteristics of both signs. Hence you belong to the cusp. The residence in a sign constitutes 6 days. Any time less endows one with some of the qualities of the preceding sign. The cusp of Leo, Virgo. August 22nd to 28. Persons born on any of these 6 days make excellent and intelligent citizens. They partake of the strong combination of fire and earth. The earth needs the sun, and these natives apparently understand that need. Both the men and women are fond of everything that grows. They are also tremendous workers, and when educated are logical thinkers. They have a natural ability of taking the good things of the earth to themselves and enjoying them. They make excellent physicians and teachers, and their ability to convince is remarkably pronounced. The heat of Leo is modified by the coolness and solidity of the earth, so that there is not so much temptation to take offense as prevails if the two signs were taken separately. They are true children of nature and like to spend most of their time out of doors, wearing as few garments as possible. But when it is necessary to live within four walls, they demand the best quality of wearing apparel combined with the latest style.